Alright, we are. Go ahead and go check that, like you just said. Should be good to go. No cams today, so that should be fun. Gonna be third person streaming.
Should I start doing a thing earlier on in the week when the track comes out, where I just make some makeshift ones in case they don't come with the track?
Oh, they never do come with the track.
Well, then I'll start doing that and testing them throughout the week before the race.
Well, it doesn't matter. I never get to stream Supercross. This is only like a one-time deal because it's really awesome out weather where I live, and we decided not to go bowling. So I decided to stream real quick, and then I'll go enjoy the weather.
Nice Christmas, Wills.
All right, so
your cursor. Don't forget to move your cursor when the race.
Oh my God! It's just a cursor.
Oh, of course, I tab into Sim and got your boy Senna the Snail. 2 minutes until UID grab.
Yep. Well, I guess go ahead and pull up the points. Get that all going. That's blue meat. Oh. Word of my heart. Na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Wait, what does that mean? Did Tiz just like leak some information?
What?
He said, I can't add you in if you're not signed up, and plus you're not top 10 in points.
Well,
does that mean what? Guess I'm never signing up.
Well, I wouldn't take it for granted. You'll be the one round you need to do good in and everyone shows up.
You're right. Oh, remember the guy from the C-Class, his name was like Dieter or D. It's his name's Dieter Williams from MXGP. He just I guess he PM'd me sometime during the week saying how you pronounce his name. Oh, you know what? I have a wrong setup on.
You see them pictures I sent to the Facebook group of the helmet?
No, I didn't.
It's so weird.
All right. Go ahead and pull up the points real quick for the 250 class. Give me a top 5 rundown, what we got to expect tonight. So we got heat 1. Getting ready to go here. Looks like we got couple of your points contenders. We got Rasmus, James, Alex. A good bit of we got some of your top point guys. Top guys in points. That actually makes a lot more sense.
Interesting. Everyone from the top 5 apart from Rasmus hasn't missed around. James hasn't missed any, Matthias hasn't missed any, Axel hasn't missed any, Alex hasn't missed any, and then there's Rasmus with 2 rounds missed.
Well, Thias, everybody's here. Rasmus is here. Yeah, Heat 1 is really stacked. I was just gonna... So looks like Timmy Carlson is not top 10 in points, so he will not be added in today, unfortunately for him.
You see Maxime in the chat.
Oh, yeah.
Timmy asked for like a third time, and he just disconnects after that.
I guarantee the stream's gonna be a little bit lighter today since this is the first time we've ever streamed Supercross, and this is probably the only time we'll ever stream Supercross. But, so, that's why I was just saying, like, there's only three people now. I know as soon as we started GP, there was already, like, 15 to 20 as soon as we started. So I figured it's gonna be a little bit lighter today. Which is all good. Still gonna do it. Ice Blue Mink. Why do I keep saying that song?
Warm up lap.
Damn, son, where'd you find this one? Takes me forever to load in on, like, I just loaded in. It takes me forever to load in when I stream AMs, but I always seem to load in fine when it's just, like, me racing with, like, pros.
That's probably because you have a lot of the skins downloaded for these cars.
Yeah. I could see a good bit of skins.
We already got Rasmus up in first, that might be a bit of a hint towards how tonight's gonna go.
Oh, yep, no cams. Darn it! Alrighty.
I'll start making them even for GP as a just in case, even though GP always seems to come out with them.
No, that's because Justin makes them. Mm-hmm. We're gonna go with Mr. Jameis off the start. He's got a good jump. Looks like Lundqvist on the inside. Oh, Rasmus beats him to it. No, it's gonna be Hergel had a good start, but it's gonna be Alex Erikson with the holy. Here in Heat 1, he's going to have Matthias Havi jump right into the back of him. That's going to be Alex out to the early lead here. Behind him, he's got Benjamin Labosse, Michael Payar, Bu Delabay, Lee Bradley, Oliver Albertson, Kevin Hergel, Rasmus Blazer, Theo Pruvas, Parkin getting around Theo Pruvas, and here comes Havi. They're going to be getting around Payar. Wow, Theo almost jumped right into the back. Say we got Lundqvist in chat, so that was not Lundqvist, that was Lee Bradley. I saw the Honda, thought it was him. My bad, Martin. Oh, wow, looks like Rasmus got into the back of Hergel over the finish line jump. So we got a battle here for fifth between Havi, Parkin, and Lee. Looks like Parkin to the inside, makes the pass stick, he's gonna have to roll though. Bradley might go double triple. Can you get the outside to move? Oh, Parkin slides it right into him.
Ooh.
That was somebody getting all kinds of sketchy. Looks like somebody dropped the front end there in the turn.
Is Benjamin your boy getting sketchy?
Oh, yep. We got a big battle here for third. Looks like Parkin with the aggressive... Ooh. Oh, no. Looks like someone must have threw us. Oh, Parkin's cutting over. Oh, wow. Oh!
That was Reed and Dungey. It's ironic how he's on a Yamaha against...
Oh, Ryan Ashman's all over the place back here. Man, this battle for the last transfer might be one to watch. And look at Rasmus! Rasmus is dead last! Uh-oh. That might not be good. This points leader, James Parkin. Oh, no! Matthias Havi's stuck on the edge! Can he get going? He's good. He's got to double the finish line, though, but Theo goes down. He almost goes down.
Who was it in the pro race that fell off that? Was it Mora?
Yes, Mora during the heat race.
He's in first, right? Alex Ericsson.
Yes, it's still Alex up front. Running.
James sitting in a comfy third, followed by Lee.
He's got about a 5 second lead. We got two people down. Lee Bradley's going to get into second.
Okay, Rasmus has gained two positions. He's in third to last.
Bunch of people are... These guys are struggling in this whip section.
Got Rico cheering him on in the chat.
Ryan Ashman. Somebody just split them all through the whip section. That was Felix Underland. Underlawn, I should say.
Racing for freaky.
Ashman. Oh man, these guys are all over the place in this heat.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh my. Woo! Oh!
Michael onto the Mitchell. How do you say that? Onto the back of my tires.
I look like a
Rasmus
James.
Gaining a good couple of spots from that.
I look like a James Stewart to Ricky Carmichael back at Unadilla.
Yeah.
Oh man.
One you mean.
Yeah. Rasmus.
Shoot was on the Kawasaki, weren't it?
Yeah, and I was gonna say Carmichael being on Suzuki, but he was always kind of on the Suzuki. Let's be real.
Yeah, Honda for a while, but
we looks like we got Timmy Carlson back in chat asking to be in the race still. Looks like Rasmus has already jumped up into the transfer spot. He got around the Suzuki rider of Ryan Ashman, and he's gonna get around Theo Pravas, and Ashman's going down the whip. So these whip sec, this whip section's been just getting the best of some of these riders, but it's all the 101 Designs KTM rider of Alex Ericsson, or should I? Is it Ericsson or Ericsson?
No, it's just Ericsson.
I think it's Ericsson.
That's why he always moans at you for saying his name.
Well, I'm gonna continue to say that because I like that name.
Whiffy banter.
Well, either way.
Oh, two friends that may seem to get together tonight. Practice a lot. James in second, Alex in first. Very close to each other in the points.
Alex Ericsson anyway. Coming into the last lap here. Yep. He's just going to get it too, actually. If he was just a little bit quicker, he wouldn't have actually done it. But anyways,
I think he means
Alex.
Slower.
Yeah, a little bit slower. Yeah, my bad. So, he gets the white flag, so you might have a battle here for second. Keep an eye on the transfer spot for ninth. Oh, wow, James. Oh, man. I thought he was going to come up short on that finish line because he like seems like he was in real high gear. I didn't think he was going to get it, but...
I think it's because he's been practicing the 450 outdoors lately.
Well, either way, we got Lee Bradley. Yeah, big gap back to from fourth to fifth. But it's going to be the 101 Designs KTM rider of Alex Ericsson coming across for the Heat 1 victory here in the 250 amateur class. And second plate. Oh my gosh. In second place.
Rasmus is in 10th.
I was just going to say your red plate holder of James Parkins going to take second. Lee Bradley third. Bu Delabay is fourth. Theo Pruvas is going to be fifth. And Matthias Havi with the front flip in sixth. But we're going to watch this. See if Rasmus can run down Payar. Payar is getting all sorts of sketchy in the whoops. See what Rasmus can do. He's pushing.
Getting that front wheel up for extra speed.
He's doing all he can. I don't think it's going to be enough.
Add a pro taper sticker to his bike for an extra 25 horsepower.
Payar might just hang on to this, and I think he will. Michael Payar is going to take the last transfer out of this heat one, so it's going to be Rasmus Blazer. Rasmus ran a 58.7 the last lap.
Oh, that's a lot faster than I was doing in my race.
So, looks like Rasmus is going to be going to the LCQ now. I wouldn't think Rasmus has too much to worry about. He know the speed is definitely there, so I think he'll be just fine.
If he gets a good start, he's in no matter what. But we still got heat two before that.
A lot of people saying rip to Rasmus in chat. I'm actually going to go ahead and message line zero since... there we go. But out of this, it's going to be Alex, James, Lee, Bu, Theo, Benjamin, Dorano, Matthias, and Michael Payar. Out of Heat 1, looks like we're getting a lineup now for Heat 2. And here we got Lundqvist, Lake, Lane, Edward Heather, Mads Blazer. So it looks like we have none of the... I don't think anybody in this heat is in title contention.
Was Axel in that heat?
Huh?
Was Axel Chotin in that heat?
I did not see Axel, but honest to God, I didn't see Axel in the lineup check for heat 2, so you might have a no Axel Chotin this week. Unless I could be misreading the thing and could have just missed his name, so I could very well be wrong.
In that moment, you realize you have James in the chat asking me if I can spot for him.
Oh, yeah, I know. I saw him earlier. He can come in here if he wants to hang out, but he's going to be listening
to you. You could have told me that. That was, what, 20 minutes ago, and I've just seen it.
Yeah, he's been asking. So, looking for Axel. Well, we do have an Axel Chotin. So, Axel Chotin is in Heat 2. So, but he's the only title contender in this Heat, if I'm correct.
I believe so.
I'm going to see a good bit of skins in here. We got Pablo, Buendini. Actually, I like that gear he's running. But, Team Slice. Running the stock Slice gear, too. Antonio Castellano. Almost gets hit by Axel. So, we're going to watch Axel. We got to watch Axel this race. With him being in the seat, being a title contender, make sure he gets into the main. We're gonna go with Lundqvist off the start, if I can find him. There he is. We're going with Lundqvist off the start, since he's got a pretty good gate, and I like his setup he's got rocking there. From the DTR Racing Squad. He's actually... might actually get this whole shot. I think I'm gonna call this one. Yeah! Lundqvist is gonna get the whole shot. So, I ended up calling that one there. That's a first. Edward Heather goes down. In the first rhythm section, we got Quentin Vassiar. Oh, wait a minute. Is this the brother of Vaseline? You know who I'm talking about, Lewis. Wow, that was close. Oh, Ben Lake just can't catch a break. He had Oliver Gergeding almost land on him, and then he ends up getting killed anyways by Danny. What does the fox say? So...
Danny put in a couple of rips in Ben's fast house gear.
Oh, man.
Not be happy.
Yeah, ain't that the truth? So, now we're going to watch... Where's Chotin at? Oh, man. Oh, wow. Oh, my gosh. They're all splitting through Tom LeMain. I'm sure he does not like that. Pablo... Danny, where's the fox say? Oh, no. He's struggling. Chotin is not... Where's Axel? Axel's actually only in 10th. He did just make a pass up in the 8th somehow, so somebody must have been off the track. So, like I said, we gotta watch Axel, as he's one of your title contenders. He's in 8th right now. He's got Pablo Budini, Beninu, I don't know how to say his name. Quarantine Mary is in 10th, messing up the rhythm section. Watch this battle here for 7th as it develops, as Sebastian Schellig-Ford messes up out of the whoops. Oh, man. Dooley's Headweathered. Why do I keep calling him Headweathered? I keep looking at his name and calling him Headweathered. Oh, my God. I feel so dumb. Oh, man. Well, anyways, I'm just going to keep going with it. So, Headweathered makes a great pass.
Did you just call him Headweathered?
Yeah, I keep calling him that. I don't know why. That's the new nickname. That's the new nickname for Edward Heathered. I can't say his name, dude. It's so weird. Edward Heather. He doesn't go down. He stays up. Oh, and once again, we got Ben Lake on the ground. He's just going to have everyone run into him. Dude, I can't say his name. Try to say his name out loud right now. Say it.
Well, Edwards.
Yeah, Edward Heather. Like, say his first and last name quick, and it's so hard to say.
Edward Heather.
Okay. That was lucky.
Luck.
Oh! Well, Headwither just got taken down.
Headwither.
I can't.
Someone make him a...
Oh, my God. Either way, whole shot and checkout for Lundqvist. Not
bend down again.
It's a whole shot and checkout for Mr. Martin out here on the DTR Racing Honda. So you're going to go under the bridge here and continue his dominance in this Heat 2 race. Kyle Lane running in second, Axel Chotin in third for Magic Racing, so Axel looks like he'll be into this main no problem. Oliver Gergeding, and then We got Edward back here in 5th, Quintin Vassiar in 6th, Sebastian Schillingford in 7th, Quarantine Mary in 8th, Mads Blazer 9th, and then we have Pablo, who goes down to the turn with, looks like, Danny Fox. So we're going to watch Ben Lake now.
P7 crashed.
Oh, what am I doing? Okay.
He's going into 9th. Oh,
looks like Lake, yep, like you just said. Looks like he has...
He's going to improve some drift skills.
We're going on board right now with Ben.
Release your inner Tyson.
Looks like he has a decent gap behind him. All he needs to do is stay consistent. He'll be in this main, no problem. Looks like these whoops. Oh, he's getting all over the place. He's good. So he gets to the whoops just okay on that Suzuki privateer. And somebody went down. That was Mary. And it looks like Antonio Castellano is going for the kill. Oh my god, he tried to do the Justin Barcia there on Alex Ray, but it did not pay off that time. And it looks like the battle for ninth has settled down a lot, as Mads Blazer is now the one on the outside looking in. He's going to get killed. Oh, Danny Fox was going for the... Just say it. We're going to have to watch that line tonight. Looks like a lot of people keep trying to...
Kyle Lane is hunting Martin down right now. He dropped his lead by 6 seconds.
Will, calm down. I see you in chat. Just tally up whatever I owe you. I'm broke. Stop doing this to me. Alright, anyways. Lundqvist does a nice 10-second lead, though. Lane.
Oh.
Oh, God. I don't know what that was. A little bit of
that
open,
was amazing.
Open C action coming over here into the 2 for the AM class. Lundqvist is off the track, but it's not going to affect him too much. And looks like they're going to go... The same distance as the Heat 1 race. Looks like they just beat it too, so...
Ooh, Axel challenging for second.
Oh, Lundqvist slides out. Lundqvist might be feeling some pressure right now as a lapper got up right in front of him. We're going to watch who that is. That was the Tom Lemoyne. As Sebastian Schillingford is doing the Matt Agate and getting stuck in the Davalos bales. Somebody went down. I don't know who that was. Oh, wow! Okay. I'm guessing that guy was invisible because Kyle Lane just basically ran right through him. Oh. Man. Labbers are playing a huge part in this race, actually.
Lead Lundqvist down is 3 seconds.
Yep, Lundqvist is going to take the white flag. Like I said, once again,
oh,
as
Kyle
you guys...
stuck with a lapper.
He's going to come up short. He's all right, though. Like I said, once again, though, unfortunately, we have no cams. I don't know who the person is that has the cams and who I can get them from. I never stream. Well, I don't usually stream SX. This is more of kind of just like a one-time deal since I'm home. But we're going to do some old-fashioned third-person streaming today. And we're going to have a good time. So, like I said, once again, still Lundqvist out in front on the DTR Honda ride. Choten's down right before he goes under the tunnel. But I think he'll get up just in time to... continue his ride in third. Let's go back to the ninth place battle. So now it's Mad Blazer who had taken over the final transfer spot. And Lundqvist is not going to lap 12th. Oh, wow. Danny Fox got all sorts of sideways going over the bridge. So Lundqvist is going to come across for the Heat 2 victory. As we're watching Pablo come up short. He probably should just DC at this point. As he will not be making this main. Kyle Lane is going to get second. Axel Choten looks like he's going to ride consistently into his third place position. And he comes across in third. Edward Heather is going to come across in fourth.
Got some more back marker action going on with this battle for the last transfer spot.
Looks like Ben Lake made his way all the way up to fifth. And Quintin Vassiar crashes right on the finish line jump. Gets it going. Oh, wow. Battle for seventh is intense. We're going to have to... If we have a race today where it's down to the wire for the win in that turn, oh my gosh.
Oh my god.
That race, that's going to be insane. And ninth place is going to be Mads Blazer, so that's going to be your heat too. Looks like Danny Fox trying to do the same thing, and that's not going to work for him. Actually, yesterday in that very turn right now that we're looking at with Danny Fox, I actually made a pass in my heat race where somebody went to the inside, and I cut down so hard and passed him, like, just, it was so sick. Like, that turn's pretty sick.
Words cannot explain.
Nope, but.
I'd like to point out you're earlier on in the race, 7th place. rider, Sebastian, finishing dead last.
Yeah, bad race for him after having a good start to this. So, so it's going to be Lundqvist, Lane, Choten, Heather! Why can I not say this guy's name without messing it up? Oh my gosh. I keep thinking Edward, and I keep wanting to say Heather. Ah!
Well, you're still better at talking than you are at playing Essex.
Yeah, well, that's true.
I'm rusted.
Ben Lake is 5th. Quintin Vessiar 6th. It's going to be Antonio Costello 7th. Courtney Mary Bads Blazer. Karen, you can come in if you want. Lewis said that he wants you in here.
Oh, did I?
Mm-hmm. Next up, LCQ for the 250 amateurs. So looks like all the heavy hitters are in the main so far, except, well, actually, I lied, because we don't have Mr. Rasmus is not in the main yet, so we're going to make sure to keep an eye on him during this LCQ. Wow, that whoop section is not fun.
Oh, I love it when people like Gaitan spam letters in the chat.
Oh, Lewis.
What?
You set the channel for two people. I had it at 4.
No. It may have been done for reasons. It may not have been.
Is this warm-up? Yep, this is the warm-up check here. Lineup check, not warm-up check. That made no sense.
Yep.
I'm going to go ahead and see if I can pull a whole shot on a 450 against 250s at AMs. Oh, look at that! I don't, because I'm off when it starts. Oh, wait, actually, I might get this. Hold up. Is that Rasmus?
You're taking it seriously.
No, I still lost! Ah!
That's because Rasmus is good at SX.
It's just a whole shot. I'm just not good at starts.
Still SX.
Why am I fucking seesawing through these whoops so hardcore? I did not mean the custom stream. I didn't mean to say it! Stream. It just slipped out of me. That made no act. It's not what I meant to say. If we could have a track with no whoops, that'd be awesome. I go to look at Seattle's, MX versus ATV, whatever you want to call it, track map thing. I'm like, alright, let's see how many whoops we got. Hopefully it's just one small section. Nope! Freaking two long, big sections right back to back. I'm like, oh my god. So, looks like Seattle's not going to be a fun track for me. I say we're getting a restart here. Alright, let's get it. Well, freaking, Wednesday is going to be my first, or not my first, but, 450 RF again. First time racing that since, well, I don't even know what round it was, but oh no, Rasmus just got destroyed off the start. He would have had the whole shot, but somebody on the Husky Dino just destroyed his life. That would have been Oliver Gajerding. So just like that, Rasmus gonna have to come from the back of the pack. I mean, not really, he's in seventh, so
Felix Anderlund out front.
Oh, people are getting all sorts of sketchy in this whip, so at least I'm not the only one struggling in them whips. Hergel's gonna get landed on. Oh, Lord! Hergel slowed up to try not to get landed on. Oh, wow.
Oh, Anderlund made a mistake.
Oh, my gosh, watching these guys. Oh, my Lord! Where are they going? Why is my voice doing that? I don't know.
Oh,
anyways,
Danny Fox.
Yep. Second. What did the Fox say is down? Sebastian Schillingford just trying to get through this section, but Blazer's already into a transfer, so I think Rasmus should be fine to go into this main. Hope a bad gate pick, but Felix and Rasmus run 1 and 2. The battle is going to be back for the 3rd, 4th positions because it's going to get crazy. It's like Payar is already exited. look up. I want you guys to spec last place real quick and just see how Payar DC'd. You probably don't have, I don't, well, for me anyways, it shows like his ghost. And Payar basically DC'd as he was falling off of the bridge. But anyways, it's Felix Anderlund out front from the hashtag Freaky Slow. Suck a trade a Yamaha rider of Rasmus Blazer in second. Let me make sure everyone knows. And it's still Pablo in third. And then it's Todd Lemoyne. Oh. So, oh, wow. Battle for sixth. Holy jeez. Danny Fox and Oliver Albertson. As Albertson just decides to go right over the bars.
Rasmus just got straight up into a bum because Anderlon pushed him away.
Well, that's all right because Anderlon
has just gone down.
Yep. So, it's like this top four has actually kind of spread themselves out. I don't think they need to worry too much. As long as they don't go down, they actually... I don't know. Danny Fox is lurking. Same thing with Hergel. He's there if anything happens, so... Keep an eye on that whoop section tonight. Looks like Blazer's just going to get across the line. We're going to have two to go here in this 250 amateur LCQ. See if Blazer can run a burner. So Rasmus Blazer racing in the 250 Pro class, GP, and racing in the amateur class here in the Supercross series. It's the with the new license system, if you have an A card, you can choose the race pro or you can choose the race amateur. It's a really great system the way they're doing it this year, letting AMs kind of get a taste of the pro class if they feel they want to, and I think Rasmus is a prime example of that as he's been trying to race pro and GP and then still racing the amateur side of things in the Supercross series. So make sure to get an A license if that's what you want to do. We have a battle shaping up here. Wow, we have a three-way battle for second. So make sure none of these guys take each other out as Blaze is going to get the white flag. He runs a 59.7.
And jumps off track.
I got to watch this right now. Oh no! Why? That was so dumb. I'm just going to call you right out on stream. That was Todd Lemoyne. There's no need for that. You're in a transfer spot. Why are you trying to do that for third? You don't need to do that. So, we're going to make sure to keep an eye on this, though. As long as nobody... it's not going to matter now. Hergel was down right on the finish line. It looks like we already have rage quits on back, so... I think this top four should be safe, so it looks like we have just a nice little calm LCQ today. Lemoyne almost went down, but Rasmus is going to get up just in time. He'll get up just fine. We'll keep an eye on Lemoyne. If he makes any small mistake, any crash by Lemoyne, and Ashman is really the only guy that has a chance in this. So we'll keep an eye on Lemoyne. He rides this thing out. He'll be in. See Ashman over there in the other section. He gets through the whoops clean. I might just do it for Lemoyne as he only has a couple turns to go. So should be Todd Lemoyne taking your final transfer spot out of this LCQ.
Bowles with the win.
Gets around the last couple corner. One jump to go, and Todd Lemoyne is into the main. And that's
seconds.
That's gonna
play Bodinier.
So that's going to set up your field for the 250 Amateur main event tonight here in St. Louis. So it's going to be Rasmus Blazer. Is it Bowser? Rasmus Bowser is going to get the win. Felix Anderlon second. Pablo Boudini third. And Todd Lemoyne gets the last transfer spot in fourth. So that is your main event for tonight. Is Lewis still here?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Next up, your main event. So go ahead and pull up the points real quick, Lewis, and give me a top five rundown. If you can.
Alright. Leaders. You got your boy, Skinny James, in first with 199 points. Second, Matthias Havy in second, like I just said, twice. EG. 193 points. Third, Axel Choten with 180 points. Oof, Alex Eric Assange, as you like to say, with 176 points, and then fifth is Rasmus with 175 points.
Yeah, so
fourth and fifth really close.
Yeah, everybody's
and
close.
First and second too.
And third's kind of a no man's land.
Yeah, Axel.
But I mean, still, anything can happen. Like I said, these points, these last races are going to be insane. Any small mistake by any of these riders, and it's—I mean—that that could be the championship right there out of the window, because they have one bad race, and I mean, it could be over for them. So, this race is going to be going a total of—I don't know, because I can't see it in chat, so I don't know what they actually are going to be going.
Oh, they're still in warm up at the moment.
Yeah, I know, just warm up, but I'm just saying. It's going to be
P4 and try and say his name quickly. Now P3.
Edward Heather.
There you go.
Alrighty. It's like Eric Sainz checking out the lines back here with James Parkin. They're in the dead last positions, probably where they'll finish. Ben Lake's just getting up from a nice, good old dirt nap. And, just waiting on the restart. It's a minefield through the whoop section. I think the key, I would have to say, the keys to this race, back up on the start equals a DQ. That's the first time I've seen that put in chat, so. But I'd have to say the key to this race tonight is getting through the first whoop section. Or obviously the whoop section. There's only one whoop section. Is getting through the whoop section on the first lap. That's the key to this race, in my opinion. Because I feel like that whoop section is going to be just absolute mayhem. Would you guys agree?
Well, it's like getting through the whoop section every lap through.
Well, yeah, I'd say getting through the whoop section every single lap will be big, but honest to God, getting through the first lap is going to be huge. But we're going to go with Lee Bradley off the start. He's got a nice inside gate. Only got to cut off one guy, and he should have it. It's like Lundqvist. It's going to be Lundqvist again. Lundqvist had the whole shot in the heat race. It is Lundqvist. So Lundqvist pulls another whole shot here out of this main event. So where is your points leaders? Starting with Blazer. He's in 7th. Erica Sasson's in 9th.
Aggressive.
Parkin, Javi, and Choten's going to be the worst out of all this. So Choten's going to be the one having to work from behind. So through the whoops section, it looks like actually it was very clean for the most part. A couple people have gone down, as it looks like Heather goes down. But out front, it's going to be Lundqvist. So came off a good hole shot in the heat race, and he's looking to try to repeat his heat race and check out.
Whoa, what was that all about?
So Blazer and Alex, though, are 3rd and 4th, and 2nd place in points is Javi. Where is he at? He's in 6th. 3rd is, oh, wow! What just happened to Alex there? Javi, oh, the pileup! Oh, where's the flagger when you need him? Call an EMT because they're all piling up. Oh, my lord! Oh, oh! Dorno Plevaults just lands a 540 underflip. Give him the gold medal in X Games Best Trick because he's bringing his A game today. Oh, man.
But mine, Lundqvist, trying to check out.
I don't know if you guys saw that by Dorno, but that was an amazing save. But yeah, like you said, though, it's Lundqvist out front trying to do exactly what he did in his heat race. So there was a massive pile-up, though. Changed up a lot of positions. But for the most part right now, this points chase, you got to watch, because Blazer right now sits in 4th or 5th in points. Lewis, where is he sit at?
5th.
5th. Okay, so he's the guy right now that needs the most points, and right now he's going to be gaining that. But don't count out Alex. He's in 3rd.
We've just seen a replica of James Armstrong and Spencer Turley in the RF Pro-Main. His first lap. Thornton Merry taking out your points leader in that 180 turn before the whatever wall jump thing that is.
Oh, wow, Blazer getting all sorts of sketchy. So, looks like this
definitely
top
unneeded, especially towards your points leader.
This top two is definitely started to check out.
Oh, mad. Going for the punt on the points leader again.
So we got to keep an eye on Alex, though, because he's what? You said he's in 3rd in points, right? Or 4th. He might be 4th.
Alex is 4th, but Axel Choten backed up on the start.
So Axel got a kick?
They haven't done anything yet.
Oh my gosh, these guys are all sketchy in the whoops. Like I said, this whoop section is going to be playing a huge factor, and these guys are all hitting each other.
They're like, raging in chat as well.
Oh! It's like, yeah, I'm looking in chat.
Battle for the leads, Rasmus 0.2 down on...
Looks like they're not doing anything to Chotin, but... Looks like Karma might be playing a huge factor in Chotin right now, as he's all the way back in 16th anyways, so... But Parkin needs to have a... Oh no, Parkin might land on Javi! Barely jumps over him. So it looks like...
The people that have tried to punt him this race already is unreal. The amount of people who have is unreal.
So you gotta pay attention then to the fact that 1st and 2nd in points are literally 12th and 14th, so... The people that are going to be making a huge point deficit come back on this right now are going to be Blazer and Alex. So, and looks like we got a battle for the lead shaping up. Is Rasmus is definitely want to try to get around Lundqvist and pull away. Went for the triple in. He definitely is running a faster pace, but don't sleep on Lundqvist. He's running just as fast laps, and consistency could play a huge factor as lappers are starting to come into a... to play already 4 minutes in. Rasmus Blazer at the inside. Backs off. Gives a little love tap.
Nothing dirty.
That was a very clean pass. Lundqvist is going to power to the inside. Blazer back to the inside. Oh, Lundqvist scrubs right past. What a great battle we got here in St. Louis in this class. Oh, I'm surprised Blazer did not go for the inside there. Squares up. Oh, washes the front end out. So he's still there, though. So he's... But wow, they have really gapped third place. So honest to God, at this rate, nothing is done though, because we have a long race to go, and lappers are going to be huge on this track. So I did want to say that I was just going to be between Blazer and Lundqvist, but like I said, anything can happen on a track like this. But it looks like that's second place in points. Matthias Javi is getting lapped only 5 minutes into this thing. Man, that is not good for Javi. Look at the... Oh, man. Oh, man. And it looks like we've lost Alex Erikson, as he's really fell back. Well, not really fell back, but he was in third, and he's just now getting right back into... Looks like fourth, but he's gonna might get punted here by Theo. Theo keeps it clean. Looks like Rasmus has some lappers to get around, so... Lundqvist getting around a lapper. Clean... Rasmus gets around him. So it looks like there's two lappers separating second and first place. I would expect Javi to move out of the way, being the guy he is in points and knowing the situation. Knowing that he should get out of the way. There he goes. Somewhat. I don't know if he actually did that on purpose or not. Actually, I take back kind of what I said there. Meaning, basically, Javi is smart enough that if he's second in points, he should kind of know to move out of the way and not be a Chad Reed. Not that... If you thought I meant something else. But anyways, the Lundqvist is still up front, 2.5 seconds. So, what a great battle that was, though, for between Lundqvist and Blazer. We didn't really mention it, but those two were going at it there. And we might see a battle brewing again, because honest to gosh... look at the lappers in front of Lundqvist already. I mean, Lundqvist...
Take Rasmus and look behind him.
Oh, wow. Wow, I didn't even realize this. Lundqvist is already lapped up. He's going to be getting to the back of Parkin. Holy crap. So, Lundqvist and Rasmus are going to be lapping all the way up into the top five here soon, for the most part.
Wait. You just said Rasmus.
Yeah. I'm gonna stick with that, too.
It's like his god name. It's
They're like just lapping god people Rasmus. Left and right. Lundqvist, he's got a lapper. He needs to get around. This lapper won't move, but Rasmus has gone down. So is Lee Bradley. We got to watch the battle for third.
30-second gap.
Watch Alex. How do you say it's Erikson, right? Erikson. Got it! Yes, guys! I got Alex's name right. Anyways. Erikson is in a fifth. Oh, gets a little front wheel lock. He's good, though.
Hawkins about to get lapped. He's in the eighth.
Yeah, like I said, Lundqvist is just a man on a mission tonight. He checked out in his heat race, and he looks like he could be on his way to a win here, but We're only halfway into this race, as this race is... How long is this race going for? Is it 12 or 15?
15 plus 1.
Yeah, so we're going 15 plus 1, so they are halfway. Well, they'd be halfway either way if it was 12 or 15, so... Blazer went down. Or why do I keep calling him Blazer? How do you say his last name? Balzer?
Bowser.
Bowser. Oh, these names are too hard to remember. We're gonna... Alright, whoa! Lee Bradley cut all the way across the track to block Theo's line, and Theo's gonna have a lapper just fucking... Oh, excuse my language. Punt him right over the berm.
Yeah, lapper's here today playing huge part.
Yeah, we're gonna... At least Alex Ericsson is gonna get around them all, and he's gonna get in the third, and hopefully... At this point, if Alex can stay third, that's gonna be a good ride for him, because he'll gain points on James. Javi has made his way up to ninth, and looks like Choten's behind him, so...
Bowser down again.
Looks like Heather's down. So, like I said, though, Lundqvist is just taking this and running away.
He's not exactly setting like fast laps, he's just stoking.
That's all it takes.
How many sets of plastics and graphics do you think Ben gets through every week?
In the booth tonight with us, Alex Heckman, it is... the one and only Lewis Linz, and the all but steady 30 place finisher in amateur GP, Kieran Evans. either way, though, DTR Racing rider Martin Lundqvist is gone. So he got through the lappers, probably the cleanest, and making the best of it, as Ericsson's getting through this first rhythm section a little sketchy, and he's gotta watch out though, because Lee Bradley and Theo Prouvost are right there.
Have you noticed Martin's lead?
Yeah, he's
25 seconds. Crazy.
Oh man.
Nothing but consistency there.
It's crazy to think though that Lundqvist is actually gonna be getting up to the battle of sixth place.
Look at Heckman in chat.
Alright.
Oh.
It's like we might have some cams for 450 class tonight.
Heck, I'm hooking us up.
Hopefully I can actually...
Where's your points leader up to?
He's up to fifth!
As he goes down.
Oh, he's down. No. Brad, oh.
Heather
got a little bit of front. Oh, his leader Lundqvist somehow gets through there.
Leader Lundqvist.
He still got a pretty decent sized lead. I mean, at this rate, if Lundqvist keeps this up, I wouldn't be surprised if he can get up to third and lap him. Only four minutes to go. I don't know, it'd be really hard with only 4 minutes to go, but he's actually in front of points leader James, and I'm sure James now is wondering, you know, what the heck's going on, and I'm running sixth place and I'm getting lapped. I mean, it's just this, these short tracks are going to cause a lot of this. Oh wow, that was close. But let's give a little shout out to some of the guys that are having a great ride right now in this race, and now I'd have to start with Theo Prouvost. I haven't seen him run up front too many times this season. He's running a solid fourth place. So he's going to run into the back of a lapper though. Lee Bradley's even having a great race. I've seen him do pretty good on the GP side of things. Javi now has made his way up to 8th, so he's going to try to stay in this point battle as much as he can. It looks like Choten's going to be the guy that's going to be choking it away as he's in 11th. So unfortunately for the Magic Racing rider, oh no, he's stuck in the Davos Bells. He gets out. It's going again. So, looks like out of all your points, leader battles, or whatever you want to say, all the guys battling for this championship, it's going to be Choten. It's going to be the guy that's going to be dropping the most points tonight, unfortunately. So, Choten was the guy in third. Am I correct, Lewis? Yep, that's what I was thinking too, Lewis. Yep. Anyways, I'm pretty sure he was third, because I think I remember him saying Alex was fourth and Rasmus was fifth. So I want to say he was the guy in third. I'll tell you one thing, though. You got to give it... Go ahead.
Cherryton was third.
Yep. You got to give it to James, though. He is doing everything he can. He had a horrible start to this race. He's been stuck in the back of the pack. And he wants his championship. He's had this points lead, I think, from what, round two or round one? I don't even know. I think he's had this points lead from the beginning of the season. And
yeah.
It's going to be close. I don't know how far Alex is behind him and Rasmus is. Oh, we got a chance for the lead. No. So somehow Rasmus has now found his way into the lead as Lundqvist has choked it away. No.
Oh, man.
Lundqvist has led this entire race from start to where we're at now. And now it's Rasmus out front. He's going to have to get around a lapper. Gets him around him clean. Oh, man. This could be a heartbreaker for Lundqvist as he had this thing in the bag almost.
Yeah.
He's down again. So the heartbreaker happens. We've noticed a bunch of times this season, a guy that's basically led the entire race always seems to choke it right at the end. I mean, I can name multiple times we've seen that. And basically in the GP side of things, all the races I've streamed this year, I think almost every single moto, there's, like, honest to God, the leader's always, like, is choked. So, I don't think it'd be, I mean, I kind of, you would think it'd be more in Supercross anyways because of the lappers, but, wow. Unfortunately for Lundqvist, he's probably going to go back to the hauler and be throwing his helmet down on the ground pretty hard as he is going down again. So, he's going to have to watch out now because now Alex is going to be jumping up to the battle. And Alex needs these points. So if Alex can get around Lundqvist, it's about a 6-second gap. Any little mistake by Lundqvist. And just like that, I mean, look at this, Karen. It was 25 seconds for Lundqvist, and now it's completely opposite. Now Rasmus has 25 seconds. So it's amazing how these AM races can basically change like that. So, wow. So just like that. Rasmus Bowser is gonna steal this win here at St. Louis and gain even more points as he's fifth in points, so I would have to say, not knowing what the points are looking like, I would have to say Rasmus is gonna jump past Axel Chotin and even possibly Matthias Havi. Or no, not Matthias Havi.
Going 1 point down on Alex, so he's going to go past Alex.
Oh, yeah.
He will go past Axel.
So he will get past Alex. So even with Alex having a great ride, Rasmus is having a better one. So now, oh, man. So
third in their championship.
So it's taking your main event win here, Rasmus Bowser. Lundqvist has still a great ride in second either way. As he gets to this whoop section, he should be alright. So it's going to be a second place for Lundqvist on the DTR Honda machine as long as he gets through these couple of corners here. Oh, wow, he's having lappers. Yeah, I just saw that.
I don't think Martin's going to be too happy with that, but...
Yeah, he had this thing, but...
He's probably got a lot of protests to be getting on with.
Ericsson's going to get a third, so Alex runs a steady race, gets a third, keeps his points championship hopes alive, as Parkin, he had Vassiard come across the track and try to punt him. I think that's what that was.
Yeah.
That was weird, I just saw that. He must have had, oh, that was weird, but anyways, Parkin's going to get a fifth. That's a pretty good ride from where he was, and your last man on track is Vassiard. He's just... I don't know what he's done. Either way, your top 10 rundown at the moment, though, is going to be Bowser, Lundqvist, Ericsson, Pruvas, Parkin, Vassiar, Havi, Chotin, Bradley, and Bew. So, or Delebe, whatever you want to say. So it looks like Lee Bradley had a pretty bad race. He was up towards the front early. But, wow. So looks like we are going to have to get a kick on Tom LeMoyne, as I saw him on the side of the track earlier in this race. Yep, he gave up on his hopes in this race at lap 5. So we got a bunch of rage quits. But wow, so the points are going to tighten up even more. As Parkin gets a 5th, he's going to lose points to Ericsson and Bowser, whatever you want to call him. So he's going to lose a couple points, but I think for the most part, Parkin should hang on to the lead as Happy gets a 7th. So even Happy stays in this championship hunt. He gets a 7th. No change in cuts. Choten gets an 8th, so at least he tried to do the best he could. But that's going to be it for the 250 class. I'm going to go quickly go ahead and look for these cams. Make sure I can get them working. So, as I am getting spotted onto the gate. So, I do have the cams. Let me go ahead and get them in. Hopefully get them working, unlike the other week where it did not want to work for me. So, thank you to the one and only Mr. Alex Heckman. He helped me out the other week for the RF stream, and
Where'd you get them from? The Twitch chat?
No, he helped, or he sent them over the, whatever you call it, Skype. He sent them over Skype. I just gotta make sure to find them here. Looks like we have a little while until UID grab. Looks about 5 minutes. Am I correct?
Yeah, about that.
Alright, now I gotta try to find how to do this again because I don't even know how the heck I did it the first time. Oh.
You put it into where you find your lap time.
Oh, that's true. I gotta go do that. Let me make sure to not have a black screen here. We'll have a get some popcorn ready screen.
Can you send them to me over Skype as well?
Yeah. It's getting hot in my room, jeez. So man, what a race in the 250 class. So definitely the points are going to tighten up even more. Parkin should hang on to the points lead though.
Yep.
That was definitely a good one. But now it's up to the 450 class now to put on a good show for us. I don't know.
It's up to the 450 class now.
Mm-hmm. Lundqvist led that whole thing, Lewis, and choked it away the last two laps, and Rasmus won.
Really?
Yep.
Yeah, Lappers, like, killed him like 6 times. Yeah, Rasmus straight up passed him.
It was your top five was Bowser, Lundqvist, Alex.
Erickson.
Yep, Alex got 3rd. 4th was crap. I was right before the finish and I accidentally hit B because I didn't realize that was going to reset me. But then it was 3rd was Alex, 4th was I think it was Prouvost.
Yeah.
Theo got 4th.
Then 5th was
James. 5th was James. 7th was Javi, and then 8th was Axel. 6th, I'm not sure who got 6th. Can somebody make sure to go on stream and make sure that my fan's not my mic's not picking up my fan?
Well, if we can't hear on Discord, then it won't be on stream, will it?
Oh, so you guys can't hear it? Oh, we're good. I don't know if you guys could hear or not.
Trust me, I would have told you if I could.
I don't know who the heck's in points for 450. I've only known the 250 class. I don't think I've been able to watch a 450 race all season.
Points still haven't updated.
They probably won't after 450. How many minutes do I have until UID, or did they not even start that yet?
haven't started that yet.
Nope, not started yet.
I don't know, we still have some good time right now. Alrighty, we have a lap time now. I'm gonna try to find this again. I forget how to do it. I think I have to go to my local app data and do it in there. But
yeah, you had to put them into the file and wait.
Yeah, I think I have to do that.
Lap time.
And Kieran, your mic didn't pick any of that up.
What happened with his mic?
His mic cut out, so it didn't pick anything he said up.
Oh, well. And you try your best, but you don't succeed.
You know, you have to, it's in the personal folder, but then you have to go, to where your lap times are.
Yeah, I know. Ah, crap. That's not what I wanted to do. There's no camera folder. I don't know what that means. Only when I open up St. Louis, it just shows fast lap and last lap. That's all it shows.
Yeah, that's where you want to put it.
Oh, just put it in there? Do I have to... Oh, well, it should be good. How do you know so much about this?
Do what she says and just put it in there.
I just remember from when... I think it was Justin told us last time.
It wasn't last time, it was like 2 or 3 weeks ago.
Yeah, well, I just remembered it, okay?
You save your every moment you have with Justin.
Sure.
You value it. Cherish yeah. It as if it's your life.
Yes.
That's cute. Do you talk over him like you do on the stream?
Oh, yes. That's so
shots.
Adorbs. So we're going to have the 450 races coming up here soon, though. Go ahead and give me a points update on that class. I'm not sure who's all in that class, who's fast, who's not.
So, people to look out for are Emilian Mabrou, who's leading the points. Anthony Delestri.
So we have cams.
Adrian Saguez, Joey Carter, Harry White.
Might go ahead and bump up my graphics so the track looks good. Actually, you know what? I'm not, because if I do something, my game might actually end up dying.
You can always put them on the iris.
Who the heck is Florian Cabell?
Maxed out apart from one setting.
It's like we will have cams for this round, for this race, whatever you want to call. Alrighty.
I want to see how your computer.
Oh, I got in right before UID sends. Grab. Sick.
Logan, did you send them over to me?
Yeah, I gotta get them over to you. Crap.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
We'll get them right now over to you.
What, we're getting over to where?
That's what she said. I don't know what I'm talking about. Let me find Kieran.
How is that what she said?
I don't know, Lewis. I don't know. I don't know.
Question your logic.
I question my
as I
life every day.
As I kick the bales on the triple. You can't tell.
Oh, gosh.
Don't worry, I question your life, too.
So we gotta watch Emilian Mabrou. Harry White's in this. A ripper?
Ripty dip.
All see too many names. I want to watch Yannick Bloom. He's third in points. He came back. He missed. He tried racing pro the first couple rounds, and he's trying to come back in this championship. So we know I got to watch Emilio Abreu, Bloom, and I'm not sure who's the other guy. We always got to keep a good eye on our good friend Senna the Snail.
It's your boy.
In this one, you want to watch Emilien Mabrou, who's leading the point.
Yep. Who's second?
Second was Anthony Delestre.
I think it's in a Delestre. Might be. I don't know. I always called him Delestre.
Well, that's a nice big pile up that I just went through in warm-up mode.
So we have sight lap going on right now. Whoop. Oh, I just did that on stream. Oh, no, crap. Oh, we're good. We didn't start yet. We're good. It didn't catch my awesome front flip. Darn it.
You still got the starting soon thing on.
Yeah, I know. I got it. I just looked down at my phone to watch my crazy sick front flip I did, and then all of a sudden I realized it wasn't even on. But we're good.
Ooh, black screen. There we go.
Is it working? And we're off and running here in 450 heat number one. And out front early, it's going to be Emilio Mabrou. So he's going to get an early start to this night of racing. Oh, wow, he's getting all sorts of sketchy through the wall. He's down in the whoops, or about the end of the whoops, actually, I should say. Adrian Sagaz is going to get around him and take over the number one heat race. That made absolutely no sense what I just said. I was gonna try to make it into something cool and it didn't work. Anyways, Senna the Snail rocking the 2016 YZ Dyno, I wanna assume. Might be 2017. Either way, I can see his gear. Wow, you think my front forks are soft.
The curse is on the screen.
Oh my god!
Stop putting your cursor on the screen and I'll stop moaning about it.
Wah, wah. Let me go ahead real quick and turn up the volume. So it's Adrian Seguaz. So only thing I'm going to apologize about for this, for the cams situation, is that my track looks a little, how do you say, a little bit blurry. Well, I don't have the greatest computer, so I do not run the highest settings.
I can ship you my computer.
Yeah. So the track's going to look a little weird, but other than that, if it doesn't, it shouldn't bother too many people, I would hope. Either way, we are off and running here in the 450 class. Heat number one, it's Adrian Seguaz, the XTC factory teammate of Emilio Mabrou, points leader in second. Hugo Crescent is in third from MT Factory. Marcus Kaim in fourth. Jesse Carter fifth. He's in a battle with Bloom. It looks like Bloom might have the inside line coming down to the turn. He gets around him. So Bloom now takes over the fifth place spot. Jesse Carter is going to try to regain that position back. Senna de Snails in 7th, Nicholas Bloom 8th, and then Anthony Rigadari 9th with Mermet. So here we find Alex Mermet. I know him from the GP side of things. He had a really great start to the season and has really fallen off the pace and lately. So I'm not sure what happened to Mermet. He was a top. Whoa, that's loud. I'd like to see Mermet get up there and have a good race today. He started off the season great in GP, fell off the face of the earth, and I'm not sure how he's been doing in Supercross. Like I said, I haven't been around. This is my first race all season. I think I've even been home, so Either way, having fun today, doing some streaming for the Supercross side of things, and it's Adrian Seguaz out front. Still, with his teammate in second, Hugo Croissant is in third. Jesse Carter has moved up to fourth with Bloom now in fifth. Sending the Snail sixth. Looks like Marcus Kane was the guy they've gotten around. He's going to drop back to seventh. He's going to have Nicholas Bloom jump over his head. So we're going to watch the battle here. It looks like for the last transfer, possibly, it could be shaping up as it is. So it looks like Mermet and Anthony are going to be going at it for ninth. So let's keep an eye on this. See if Mermet can do anything here. Mermet's getting all sorts of sketchy through the Dragon's back, but so is Anthony, so doesn't really lose or gain anything right there. Same rhythms all the way through. Still pretty even. See if Mermet can maybe get the triple win. He doesn't go for it. Nope. Stay the same lines. It's like Mermet's actually going to have to go on-off. See if he can get a drive through the whoops, possibly. Anthony, he's going to hand the position. As Mermet kind of just jumped right over him. He went right over top of him, so... That was kind of the only battle, really, for the last transfer is Hicks, Hugo, and Florin Curabelli are really far back, so that's really it. But back up front, it's still Adrian getting around a lapper. Mabru now gets around him. Croissant is running a good race. Crescent, it might be Crescent. I don't know. I'm saying Croissant because I keep thinking of food, so...
But did you just see Amir Mabru's like corner speed around the track's insane?
Yeah, Mabru's a fast guy. He's been racing the pro scene. I've seen him now in the GP races. He's not the best lapper to me, I must say. Just calling him out, taking shots. But I remember in the GP circuit I was running, I think a third or a fourth at Leon in the 450 pro race. I think it might have been Moto 1. And Mabru was doing a little bit of a Chad Reed, but
he just completely blocked passes.
It all worked out well. He didn't take me down, and he's taken over the lead. So Looks like he's doing something right.
Getting the triple in.
Yep, I'm surprised to not see more guys doing that. I mean, it is a pretty hard jump. I know yesterday I never crashed in it or on it, I should say. In my heat or main event, but it wasn't easy, I must say. You had to have a pretty good little suspension preload, or you were not going to get it. And it looks like we might be coming to the... I don't know what we're on. Oh, so it looks like these guys are going 6 plus 1, so... Oh, wow! Seguaz, or Adrian, I don't know what he did there. He knifed the front end into the rut and just all popped up out. We got a battle for third shaping up between Hugo and Jannik Bloom. So it looks like all these guys, all the title contenders. Oh, Bloom and Crescent get together. That was more of a little mistake by Hugo. And I think Bloom might have just went for the aggressive pass and not pay off. It was a lapper between them. Sending to Snail runs a solid race. Jesse Carter, Nicholas Bloom, Marcus Kim. All these guys are in a safe transfer spot to the main.
Yep.
Yeah, Lundqvist, we watched that entire race. It sucks, man, that had to happen. We were cheering for you, had that thing in the bag, and it sucks. But, I mean, you at least hung on to a second, and you still have four races to go, and I wouldn't be surprised if you could maybe pull a main event win before the end of this season. And you still got GP and stuff, so just keep doing what you're doing, and I'm sure you'll win a race here sooner or later. But it's my brew out front, getting a little sketchy going into the rhythm section. But Adrian's down anyways in second, so... Just like everyone... Oh, whoa, man. Bloom just destroyed a lapper that was down. Not sure who that guy is. I do not know if I'll be streaming next week. Like I said, the whole streaming situations kind of goes... basically like day by day, so I have absolutely no idea. If I post on the forums, I'll usually post on the forums if I won't be able to make it. Like if I won't make it, then I'll post on the forum saying I can't stream. But for the most part, I'll post on the forums if I can stream or can't stream, but do not know yet. But I want to point out real quick, as I was saying that though, is that Mermet lost the transfer spot to Anthony Rigadier, so Mermet might be looking at an LCQ trip here. It's like 11th comes across the line, so
line cleanly, so
Mermet's the only guy on the track that has a chance to make this main that's not in a transfer spot now. And there's a battle between Marcus Kam and Rigadier, so keep an eye on this. Let's see if they get through the whoops cleanly, as Mermet needs something to happen. Regard is... Oh, he's down! Oh, no! And, oh, Kam hits him! So exactly what Mermet needed. Here comes Mermet! Rigadier gets up from the crash. He can't get going in time. He goes for the triple up. He actually... Oh, and Mermet goes down with Kam! So Rigadier gets handed the transfer spot. Now it's between Kam and Mermet. Mermet gets going. Kam goes for the punt. He misses.
Well, take a look at what happened.
Oh, no. So Mermet steals the transfer spot. What a great last lap finish there for the last transfer spot. So after all that, Anthony Rigadier gets the spot. He gets 8th. And Alex Mermet steals a transfer spot away from Marcus Kam. So your heat one's gonna be Emilio Mabrew, Adrian Siguaz, Hugo Crescent, Janik Bloom, Senator Snail, Nicholas Bloom, Jesse Carter, Anthony Rigadier, and Alex Mermet transferring on into the main with ease, going for later tonight's main event. Next up, it is gonna be heat 2. Waiting here for the restart. Looks like nothing is going to change though between everyone. Front flip for the fans does not work. So who was second in points again? I know it was Bloom was third and Emilio Mabrew was first, but who was second?
De La Estrella.
So that's who we're going to have to watch tonight. Make sure to keep an eye on those three, as De La Estrella's in this heat. Make sure he gets in. It's between just those three guys now, I'm pretty sure, ain't it? I think I remember checking those points and fourth was way back.
Having fun.
So we're having the warm-up lap here. See Harry White. Oh, I gotta download Harry White's stuff. He sent me all his updated stuff.
Oh, I didn't know what you said. That.
What?
He said Harry White's is. Just Harry White's.
Nah, Harry White is. It's better. I really wish more people would send their skins in. Like, I would like to see the XTC Factory guys. There's so many of them. But no, they just decide not to even send their skins. Same thing with people like even Clever School. Clever School is almost at every race. I don't have any of their skins. That's really it. Those two teams. So XTC Factory and Clever School Riders, if you're watching this, please send your skins in onto the skins threads so I can see you in the races. And if you've already sent your skins in and I just didn't download them, then please tell me and I will make sure to get them. But make sure to watch Lewis Linz's very good friend Harry White's off the start.
I've spoken to him a total of 4 times.
Yeah, well, he's a good friend. Actually, we'll go with Clement Rebellion from Magic Racing. He has a really good inside gate. Looks like he has an MT Factory guy there beside him. That's Kevin Mayar. Off the start. It might be another. Nope. It's going to. Actually, yes. I think I called another hole shot, and I do indeed. So it looks like the second gate on the inside is where the hole shots are coming from. So if you're the very. It's the second gate on the inside of the two. Those two gates on the inside are the best. I've found that out. That was actually Gathard Dubois from MT Factory, not Kevin Mayar. So either way though, those the two guys on the inside pull first and second, and Dubois and
going down.
I'm not really sure what the heck happened. That looks like that was Dubois and Turner got together going before that straightaway. But Quinnot Lucas out front, he had a very rough second moto at Leon, so he's hoping to revenge his bad moto here in Supercross.
He's out front. The Lestrian fourth, second in points. He's getting to the main.
Looks like Guillaume Manquagnon from the Blue family. And then here comes Antoine Delestray battling with Gathard Dubois. He did a little brake check there. Jay Turner is back here. We have Joanna Listusti. I don't know. Kevin Mayar, Matt Dalsey, Ryan Whitlocks, Anders Nielsen, Harry White, Matthew Perez, Clement Rebellion. Rebellion. Oh, him and Whitlocks get together. Oh, and I'm back to third-person accident. Keep an eye on the battle for ninth, though. It's seems to be where the action... Oh, wow, JLV. You are a C-U-N-T.
Oh, wow. Whoa, you disrespect the guy that made the game you've played for the last 3 years.
I didn't say it. I just spelled it out. You yelled at me for saying it on stream. You yelled at me for saying it on stream, so I'm going to spell it out.
I did not yell. I spoke with emphasis.
Well, either way, I was just calling him out right there because Matt Dalsey probably hit. I think he hit somebody in the whoops and then got front wheel lock, I think, like five. Oh! Wow! So somebody was down, and Harry White tried to jump up over him and just went right over the bar. So this battle for ninth is very interesting. Is Johan Letuste? I don't know. I think he's the guy. I don't know what is going on. Who are they all battling? Oh, my gosh. Harry White now is back. Oh, Harry White's back to 13th. So we got to keep an eye on this battle for ninth. They're all right there. Oh, as one does go down. So that was Jay Turner. He's your down rider. And I do not see a medic flag, so the flaggers are lacking very much today as Matt Dalsey just crashes in the background and Whitlock's crashes in the... And Harry White hits the Davalos Bales. Does anybody want to stay up? That'd be awesome.
The Davalos Bales.
Unless you went from first to fourth.
Who the heck's the guy out front? Never heard of him. So it looks like Julia McQuagnon. He's out front. Is it... Actually, I might be able to say the same. Guillaume McQuagnon. 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 I might actually be pretty close to that.
Nonce.
He's going to be going down in the whoop section either way, so it don't matter. Oh!
And
no. Nope. Luca stayed up, so. Delshay's third. Mayar fourth. Manu Da Silva fifth. Clement Rebellion sixth. Johan Letuste. I'm not sure how to say it. Eighth. Matthew Perez is ninth, and here comes Turner in tenth. So we'll keep an eye on Turner, see if he can run down Matthew.
For the call him the quacking nonce.
Oh, somebody's getting so sketchy in the whoops. I cannot believe these guys. Whoa, Jay Turner! Whew! He freaking flew into that turn. I'm surprised he was able to get on the brakes that hard. What's not? Oh, he's sliding out. Someone give this man some ice skates because it's a little slippery.
You had to think about that, didn't you?
I did. I did. Originally, I was going to say, like, I wanted to say something about, like, it's cold, but then that wouldn't have made sense. So I was just like, all right, I'll just say slippery. But, oh, man, Harry White's all over the place. Definitely not a Supercross guy. He's your points leader in the outdoor series, and his Supercross skills are just like mine. Sketchy and all over the place. Riding the ever-good Husqvarna made by the one and only Matthias Janus. As Jay Turner's just sucking it up back here. He definitely learned his skills from his big bro Ryan Turner, as they both suck at Supercross. Calling shots at Ryan. I'm just kidding, I love Ryan. He knows that. But after yesterday's performance, not making the main when he only had to beat a few people, I'm allowed to. We're gonna keep watching Harry White though. He's in tenth. He needs to get a pass. He needs to get around Johan, who is in ninth. It looks like now it's gonna be Da Silva, Da Silva, Da Silva. Manu Dasa. Wow, what the heck was that? Harry White with the triple up. Harry White's starting to get a little, starting to have his balls hang low because he's starting to go for it. His lag, though, was awesome going through that one section. He, like, basically floated into the face of the finish line and just, like, bounced whip. It was so sick. He's our... Him and Johan got really close. Da Silva's just going to have to try to stay patient as even Perez is back here. Actually, Da Silva is actually in ninth. So, somebody... Oh, yeah, it's Perez. So, we lost Perez. So, that's why he's in 10th. And he's going to go down again. So, it's like the battle again, once again for 9th is going to calm down. Back up front, Kwanat Luka is running away with this thing out front. He should be able to...
Like how I explained what you said to him.
As Luca is just, he's got this race on lock. He's got a nice big old lead over XTC Factory rider Antonio Delestre. Clement Rebellon is in a battle with Dubas here for the for fourth, I think it is. Or it might be third. Oh, it is third, actually. Watch this here, see if Dubas tries to do anything on Clement. Goes inside, slides out. It's going to let Clement get that. So it's going to be Clement, Rebellon in third. Got to throw out Dubas, comes across in fourth. And laggy, Guillaume McQuigg. Whoa, he goes down before the finish. He should be all right to get up in a transfer spot. So McQuignon tries to get up.
He's going to miss this. He's down in the ropes.
And he gets across in fifth as he crashes right over the finish line. Kevin Mayar, another MT Factory guy, is going to get across in 6th. Manu Da Silva, 7th place. Johanna Lestuste. Oh, we got battle for the last transfer, I think, right here. That's 8th coming across the line. 9th. Oh, it was close. So, Perez. So, it looks like Harry White does get the last transfer spot. Cuts will play a huge factor in that. So, Whitlock's Turner, Andreas Nilsson, and Matt Dalsey are going to go to the LCQ. I'm just going to wait for Cuts to see who will get that last transfer spot. But welcome to the booth, Alex Erica Sasson, as he will be joining us.
I've been talking for 5 minutes.
Yeah, well,
got
I think...
in here 2 minutes ago.
So it looks like we actually do have a change, but it does not help out anything for the transfer spots. So Harry goes up to 8th, and Johan Leitastu is going to get 9th, so nothing changes there for the transfers. But welcome to the booth, Mr. Alex Eriksson.
Hello.
Good race today?
Decent.
Gained some points on James, and you're going to gain some points on Matthias especially, but you lost a position, so.
So I'm still 4th.
Did they already update the points?
No, but I think I'm gonna be 4th because
you are gonna be in fourth.
Yeah, because Axel got to 8th and I was 3rd.
They're probably gonna DQ Axel because he backed up on the start.
Well, that's lucky for me then.
Yeah, I might have a little talk with that. I think the AMA official came out and had a little word with him, or I should say the EMF official, because this isn't the AMA.
I hope you went with me for the start in the heat race, because I got the whole shot.
I'm not sure. We didn't have... Well, I don't know if you watched this... Well, I guess you haven't watched the stream back, of course, because we're not done. But the we didn't have cams for your class, so we had to do third-person streaming. But we just got cams for the 450 class.
Gonna go J-turn for start. Oh, wait, this is warm-up, isn't it?
Why do people forget there's always warm-up laps? Gosh. Especially Lewis.
Well,
you're honestly like the one person like that just is professionalizes at not knowing that there's a warm up lap.
I always know there's a warm up lap.
I like the setup the Plus Red SX people are running. I see Andreas Nilsson's stuff and his stuff is fresh. Running that purple and white Fox setup with a nice looking Honda. I like it.
But do you like it?
This is why we can't have nice things, Lewis.
I do have nice things. I've paid for most of my nice things.
Yeah, with your mom's money.
And nothing wrong with knowing credit card details off by heart.
Oh my god, that's a lovely thing to know. But anyways, JLV moonwalks off the track, and Ryan Whitlock says the inside gate here in the LCQ to see if he can pull the holy. Gets a good jump, cuts over, and I might call another hole shot, and I think I am. So I am, like, what, 4 for 5 today on hole shots? Jeez. Caught a bunch of hole shots today. So it looks like that inside gate, if you're in, the farther inside you go on this track, is that's where the hole shots are coming from. So it's going to be Whitlock's out front early. Dowsey second. Marcus Kame is third. He had a transfer spot almost all race in his heat, so he definitely wants to make it into this main. Anders Nielsen stuck back here with Hugo and Rasmus Nordstrom, I should say. Wow! So, I'm not sure who that was. It was Jay Turner. So, let's say, I think the 450 is too much for Jay Turner. Because every time I've seen him, he's been all over the place. And I just watched him come out of a turn and loop out. So, that's always fun. So Whitlock's out front, Dowsey second, Kane third, and Archie Hicks is down in fourth. So Hugo Lenard's going to take over fourth. So the top three are looking to check out and not have to worry about what's behind them, as they are starting to pull a pretty decent-sized gap. So the battle's on for fourth, though, between Hugo Lenard, Anders Nielsen, and Archie Hicks obviously wants to get into that battle, as Florine calls it a day already, as Matthew Perez is stuck back here with Jay Turner. They have a lot of work to do, and I think there's a pile up. So first, second, and third all go down in the same turn, and that's going to tighten things up a lot as Hugo goes from fourth to the second, and Dowsey drops to third. Yeah, Whitlock's is up to fifth, or Whitlock's is down to fifth. Yeah, he was your early leader. We should be looking at two to go, as Hugo now is in second with Marcus Kame is out front. So hopefully Marcus Kame can hang on to this. He was so close in his heat.
Wow. Whitlocks and Nielsen got together. Nielsen down.
Oh, man. Yeah, Nielsen went down. So that's going to allow Archie Hicks to hopefully get into the battle. Looks like Perez and Jay Turner are going to be packing up early and going home, as they are a good ways back out of this thing. They're doing whatever they can, but man, Perez all over the place, and Turner's all over the place, and Perez over the bars. Nope, saves it. Turner back to the inside, and then they're together. So I think those two are going to be packing up early, and Anders Nielsen goes down, and out of nowhere, Rasmus Nordstrom, man, he just cleaned out Archie X. So, wow. So literally everybody from fifth on back just went down. So Turner, Hicks, Nielsen, and Perez all went down. And wow, these 450s might be too much for these two guys, as they are just looping out and going down. So we are going to be, like I said, two to go, as Kame, it is right now Kame, Hugo Lenard, Whitlocks, and Dowsey holding down your final transfer spots, as Nordstrom, he went off the bridge. So looks like it's just going to be these guys, the top four, should be easily into this main, as they're just gone. It's about almost 15 seconds, or almost 20 seconds back to Nielsen.
Whitlock's did just go down.
Yeah, Whitlock's, yeah, like you said, just went down, so very possible that Nielsen could actually get up in there if anything happens. But like we pointed out, though, Kame is out front, running away with this LCQ win. Should be easily finding his gate for the main event, as he should be taking the white flag here.
Yep.
And behind him, it's still going to be Hugo Lenard, Matt Dowsey, and Whitlock. So Nielsen's going to pray and hope that Whitlock goes down. So keep an eye on Whitlock. And I am going to watch Mr. Marcus Kame get around this last lap. Marcus Kame was an open sea rider beginning of the season.
Oh, Whitlock's down.
Oh, so let's see what happens here.
Nielsen might get past.
Oh, wow. I did not know Nielsen was going to be that close. So when you